5 murder cases with unbelievable motives. Killing is absolutely bad, but killers don't always kill for the right reasons. As a matter of fact, some motives for murder are unbelievably stupid. From fart jokes to Monday blues to FIFA World Cup, here are 5 of the world's dumbest motives for murder. Number 5. Fart jokes gone wrong. In 2012, a 16-year-old teenager from Ohio was beaten to death by her classmate, who became enraged over the victim's constant teasing. Reports said that the victim, Shakira Dorsey, was heard making fun of the suspect in front of a group of girls in their class for passing gas in public. The girl probably had too much of the teasing, so much so that she became infuriated and started beating up Shakira. The latter was brutally beaten, that she collapsed unconscious and eventually succumbed to death after the fight was broken up by a nearby adult. Authorities who arrived at the scene said they received 2 separate 911 calls. When the police arrived, an ambulance was already there, treating Shakira. Unfortunately, she breathed her last breath while being treated. The classmate was charged with murder, but her identity was withheld by the authorities to protect her identity, as she was still a minor at the time of her apprehension. Number 4. Hobo Cheetos Fight. David L. Scott is a 49-year-old man who was convicted for killing Roger Wilkes, a 42-year-old man, over a bag of Cheetos. Both were homeless people living on the streets of St. Louis when the incident took place. Witnesses told the police that the 2 homeless men were fighting over a bag of the said junk food, which the victim had in possession. When Wilkes refused to hand over the bag of chips to Scott, the man took out a knife and stabbed the victim repeatedly in the chest. A bike patrol was notified by witnesses and was given a description of the perpetrator. A police chase ensued, and soon after, Scott was arrested a few blocks away from the crime scene. They recovered from the suspect the murder weapon, which was still in his possession, when he was arrested. Upon his arrest, it was found out that Scott had an extensive criminal record, including several arrests for robbery and assault. Meanwhile, Wilkes was taken to the hospital where he was pronounced dead. Scott was then charged with second-degree murder for the crime. Number 3. When you hate Mondays. This tragic incident happened at the Grover Cleveland Elementary School in 1979, where a 16-year-old Brenda Ann Spencer lived in a house across the road. The teenager apparently had a troubled family life. Her parents were separated, and she lived with her father, who couldn't provide a decent means of living for both of them. One morning in January of 1979, Spencer took the semi-automatic .22-caliber rifle that her father gave to her as a Christmas present and began shooting at the children outside who were waiting for the school gates to open. Upon hearing the gunshots, Burton Ragg, the school principal, came outside to see what happened. He was caught in the gunfire. Another adult victim, Mike Schuker, the school custodian, was shot and killed while trying to protect the school children. A police officer nearby responded to the call, who also got shot in the process. 8 children were injured during the shooting. Right after the shooting, Spencer barricaded herself inside her house. A reporter from the San Diego Union-Tribune contacted the shooter via the telephone. When asked what motivated her to do such malicious actions, Spencer simply replied that she doesn't like Mondays. "That livens up the day," she said, referring to the shooting incident. Spencer was arrested and tried as an adult, where she pleaded guilty for the 2 murders and for the charges of assault with a deadly weapon. She was sentenced to 25 years in prison and is currently incarcerated at the California Institution for Women in Chino. Number 2. When being ungrateful is a crime. The brothers Fergus Glenn and Craig Glenn had been in a constant fight for quite a long time. From verbal tirades, their fights escalated to physical altercations. But everyone from the Glenn family was shocked when one day the quarrel ended in a bloody conclusion. In March of 2003, Craig Glenn got separated from his wife and was booted out from his home. He stayed at their family house in Wellington, New Zealand, where Fergus Glenn, an unemployed man, also lived. The evening before the tragic incident at the Glenn residence was actually a happy one. Fergus even volunteered to cook dinner for the family. However, Craig committed a mistake by forgetting to thank Fergus for the meal he prepared. According to police records, Fergus took an axe and brought it down 8 times on his brother, who was fast asleep. Fergus Glenn received a life sentence for the heinous crime. And number one, when football is worth literally dying for. All David Makioya, a 61-year-old man from South Africa, ever wanted was time to watch Germany take on Australia in the opening round of the 2010 FIFA World Cup. However, his family, consisting of his wife and two children, insisted on watching a religious show. The two parties ended up battling over the TV remote. When he failed to grab the channel switcher, he opted to change the channel using the buttons on the TV. At that moment, all hell broke loose. His enraged family started beating him. According to reports, his family banged his head against the wall several times, which caused severe injuries. Authorities later found out that the victim also had incurred a stab wound in the back. Mr. Makioya was already dead when the police arrived at the scene. All three family members faced trial for the crime. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this.